So, I'm gonna go ahead and get started. My work, so it's kind of dark down here, so I apologize. Also, I'm gonna be using this little normal saline as the med and the dilutant. So, I'm gonna be pulling it from both, or pulling both from this one, just so you guys know. But yes, so I got the 2-year-old little boy who came in with clavicle fracture and bruising. He's getting morphine for pain every 2 hours. It's about 15:45, and it's about time for him to get that morphine. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the med ready, and then we'll go into the room and see the patient. So let's see. I don't know how well you guys are gonna be able to see this. So I'm gonna pretend to foam my hands. They're washed. I'm gonna put on some here gloves. I've already got all my supplies ready. I have my flush. I have needles, my syringes, my med, alcohol wipes, and a label. The med first. The patient is getting 2 milligrams every 2 hours, which is a safe dose. And I'm gonna be pulling, or I'm sorry, he's not, he's getting 0.5 milligrams every 2 hours. I was looking at the wrong thing. He's getting 0.5 milligrams, which is 0.25 mLs, every 2 hours for pain. Okay, I've got my little label here. I don't know. It's the morphine, 0.5 milligrams, aka 0.25 milliliters, which is what I have here. I'll try to show you guys this before. 0.25, so just a little bit more. Now it's at 0.25. I don't really know how well y'all can see this. Okay, no bubbles. So I'm gonna leave this here. I'm gonna pull up my dilutant now. It's So with morphine, they said it doesn't have to be diluted, but since it has to be pushed over 5 minutes, I'm going to choose to dilute it just because it's going to make it easier for me. So I'm going to do about, I would technically do 5 milliliters of dilutin since it has to be pushed over 5 minutes, but the biggest syringe I have is 3 milliliters, so we're just going to fill that guy up. Switch over the syringe because that one the needle doesn't come off of, which is not going to be helpful at all. I'm just going to put the dilutin in this syringe instead. Now that I have the one that the lid can come off of, I'm going to take the lid off here. And then I'm going to put the med into the dilutant. Like so. Be using a sterile cap, but I don't have any, so okay. So now with the discarding all of this stuff, all of that can go to the trash. I'm gonna put the label on my medication here so I know what I'm giving. Make sure all the bubbles are out of this end. Looks like they are. So thing is now ready to rock and roll. Dilutin and med are in there. I have my flush ready to go. I've got my alcohol swabs. So now we are going to step into the patient room. I'm going to take my gloves off and wash my hands. So I'm just going to turn the computer a little bit. My stuffed monkey is going to be our patient. So. Okay, so I would foam in and then, hot dog, hello. medicine here for you. It's going to help you feel a little bit better. If you had to rate your pain on a scale of 1 to 10 right now, 10 being the worst pain you've ever had, what would you consider it? And my patient is 2, so most likely I would just have to do a pain assessment and base it on, like, I think it's the FLAC scale, the one with the faces, since the 2-year-old's most likely not going to be able to tell me his pain level. I just kind of thought about that, so I probably wouldn't actually ask those questions. I just kind of have to do the assessment. Some of the other assessments that I would want to are the vitals, which in the scenario it already gave them, so I'm just going to assume they had already been done. I would also probably go ahead and check for bowel sounds, just so I could then come back in an hour or so and reassess the pain, and then also reassess the bowel sounds, since morphine tends to slow things down. I would probably teach the parents a little bit about how and when and what they should look for, about asking for it, since it's a PRN medication. So just, you know, saying if your child looks like they're hurting, basically, we can ask for it, but they can only have it every 2 hours. I would let them know that some side effects are like drowsiness, respiratory depression, things like that. I would just kind of inform them and let them know that it tends to slow the body down. So just to watch for any major signs and symptoms, and that to let us know if they notice anything, and watch for like allergic reactions and things. So other than that, once I've done all those assessments on my patient, I'm going to put gloves on. Grab the hub of the IV. So I'm just gonna pretend here. Scrubby scrub. My monkey's gonna be so clean. Okay. So once the hub is scrubbed for 15 seconds, then I'm gonna go ahead and do part of my flush first, just to make sure that the line is nice and open. The line is patent and we are good to go. I only have one flush, so I'm going to use it at the end too. I'll go ahead and scrub the hub again for 15 seconds. Discard that. And then now I'm ready to give my med. So I'm going to take the cap off. And with the morphine, it is a 5-minute push, so bear with me. We're going to be here for 5 minutes. I'm going to get it all hooked up. And I'm going to start the 5 minutes in just a couple of seconds. And as I'm pushing this med, I'm going to be just watching the child to make sure that nothing crazy happens. If I see any weird side effects or reactions. 5 minutes is starting now. minutes. I did notice that I forgot to ask about allergies. The paperwork did say no known drug allergies, but I definitely would have asked that entering the room as well. And then also, I would have scanned the patient armband and like the computer system and everything. As you can see, I still have a little bit of the med left. I know it's really hard to see over there. And 5 minutes, and I am done. The med is now gone. So, 5 minute push IV med. Now I would do the flush as well. I would go ahead and re-scrub the hub. I would put new gloves on. I don't know why I didn't mean to take them off. So scrub the hub again. And then for the flush, you have to do, it doesn't really matter how much, but just to clear the line, you have to do the first milliliter of the flush at the same rate that you went for the injection, or for the push med. So I'm going to do the rest of this flush first at just a minute, and then about a milliliter a minute, and then I can just shove the rest in. So I'm going to start my minute. Right now. Y'all didn't see that. It shot out really fast. So that minute is up, and now I can just shove the rest of it in, which it kind of shot out on me at the beginning, so we're just going to pretend. And then that would be it. And I would ask the family if they have any questions or concerns, or if there's anything else I could do for them while I was in there. I would make sure to take all my trash and get rid of all my sharps and wash my hands. Now, I just want to like kind of re-talk about the process because this is kind of hard without being actually there. When I entered the patient room, I would have my med as well as my flush and things like that. I would have to ask the patient their name and their date of birth, check their armband and make sure that that all matches up. And then I would also ask them or the parent if they had any drug allergies, just to make sure that the chart matches what they're saying. And then I would make sure to scan all of that, scan the patient bracelet, do all that good jazz, which I literally can't do here. So, and then make sure to document the meds and stuff after you've done them. So, I'm trying to think. I think that's pretty much it. I can't think of anything, so yeah. I hope this works.